So now, let's see how we can send and receive messages in Slack. So over here, I already have my Slack opened. And now, there are three ways to communicate. So you can either go around into draft and message them in a private group. You can go around in a more public channel and then communicate there. Or you can directly message them. So if you were to go to draft and say something like, hi, what happens is that the only people in that particular group will be able to see that message. You want to make the message a bit more public, then what you can do is you can go around into something like general and say hi. And then what happens is that the message will be viewable by all of the members just like that. And they'll be able to reply out to you as well, just like this, as you can see, just like messaging in Facebook or any other social media platform. If you want to do a private communication, then you can go around into particular profile and you can see their status right here. And right now the status is active, as you can see. So I can just go around and say, hi there, just like this. And the other person will be getting that message right there and then will mention you up. So let's say, for example, you're somewhere else right here and they sent you back a message. So let's say, for example, they sent you a message and what happens is that you get this one a number right here, which notifies that you have a message that you might want to read, just like this. So that is how you can send and receive messages. And another thing that you can do is you can do mentions. For example, you can go over here. If you were to press at, what happens is that you can tag onto a particular user right over here. Let's say, for example, I want to tag TutorTube2 and say hi, just like this. And what happens is that the person will be tagged out. So now over here, if the person writes something, so let's say, for example, they write something in planning right over there. So let's say, for example, they write something in planning and messages out. You can see that planning is bolded out. That means there is a message there, but you aren't tagged along. But if you were tagged along, let's say, for example, the other person does the same thing and tags you out right over there, and then messages you out something, what happens is that you have the number icon right here. So what happens is that now that draws your attention. That means that you have been called upon by the other person, just like that. So you can be specific to whom you message, just like that. So what other thing that you can do is you can go around and emphasize your message. So this is a sample message, for example. So what you can do is you can bold this out, for example, you can italicize it, you can insert a code right here, you can give a list. So all of these settings are here in the message as well. You can also throw in an emoji right over here. So let's say, for example, you're gonna send a heart, even attach a file. All of the things can be done right over here. So you can just go around and send that out by being more specific. So you can see that this is bolded out, this is italicized, and so forth. And that is basically it. So that is how you can send and receive messages inside of the Slack software. Another thing that you can do is, if you're especially in a general area, you can go on to that particular person and then reply to that person as well. So that is something we're going to see in later lessons. So hope you guys learned something as always. And as always, please like, comment, share, and subscribe.